Hey guys, how you doing? JP Saricolia here, and this week has been an interesting week, of course, because everything that is happening with SciShow Con, with the SciShow New York Con, and a lot of, I would say, excitement from one end, because it's always exciting to expect new things, but on the other hand, there's also a lot of disappointment, because there hasn't been enough reveals to justify the time that they have spent presenting this stuff. However, just because SciShow is not really showcasing a lot of stuff right now doesn't mean that other companies are trailing behind. A lot of companies right now are really pushing the envelope with the products. They bring in stuff that it's amazing. When you look back at what happened at Shanghai at the WonderFest, there were a lot of great reveals, and next week I'll be talking about it for quite some time. I'll dedicate some videos to talk about a lot of companies that they were there and they were showcasing a lot of stuff. But one company that this week is releasing a new pre-order that I'm excited for, or at least I'm happy to see, is Kotobukiya. They released a new Captain America for the Fine Art Statue line, and it looks great. It's already on pre-order at SciShow as well. So I want to talk about it today because this piece looks amazing. And I want to really dissect the information that has been provided, the good and the bad, what I like about it, what I don't like about it. And ultimately, I want to let you know if I think you need to add this to your 1/6 Marvel collection or not. But before we get into that, I want to really look at something that I didn't get a chance to talk. And this is the Maximum Carnage Fine Art Statue. This is also on pre-order. This is supposedly coming out, or it's going to be released around February of next year. So pretty much down the line. And this is a piece that has been sculpted by Restore. And if I'm coming to the Japanese website, let me go to show you this, because I love the way the Japanese website present the pictures. So we can look at that. This piece looks amazing, as you can see. This is actually a cold cast piece. This is supposed to be a companion piece to the Artifacts Venom statue. That was the design. Let me show you this. Look at the pictures. It is a nice piece. It's supposed to be a companion, but they're promoting it as a cold cast piece. So it means that everything is sculpted on resin and cold cast porcelain. In this case, the Artifacts Venom was made out of PVC. The base was made out of polystone, or in this case, cold cast porcelain. So, which is pretty much the same thing. I don't know why they're doing that. I'm guessing that they should be the same because they're supposed to be companions. I don't know if they just decide to go all out with the Carnage this time to actually price it higher. I don't know. The concept is good. Some people have talked about it here. They have asked me to talk about this piece. So I want to talk about it. That's the reason I'm talking about it right now, because I haven't really had the chance, and I don't think I'm going to have the chance to do it later or down the road. So I'd rather just do it now. But I'm telling you, this piece looks great. I think it's a great companion the way it was designed. In a moment, I think we're going to see some pictures where he's paired with Venom. But looking at the piece of the design, I still think that the Carnage that was produced by Eric was fantastic. Eric did a terrific job with it. Of course, it's a different pose, perhaps less dynamic than this, but there's a lot of raw power on that piece just by itself. But definitely, this is an interesting piece. Look at the hands, the detail there. So I know a lot of people love Carnage. That's one of the reasons I never really review the one by Eric Sosa, because I've never been like crazy for, or you know, a fan of the character. Like right here, you can see with Venom. I did review the Venom back then, and still consider one of the best Venoms out there on the 1/6 scale. But looking at this, you can see that the size, Carnage is really tall. So this display is going to be very nice. They pair very well. They were designed with that purpose. It is a nice concept. I would say if you already own Venom and you want something to pair it with, this is the perfect companion piece. And I think they're going to pair so well for the Maximum Carnage effect. So yeah, I think that's a good thing about this piece. Now we're looking at Captain America. This is the one that I really want to talk about today. But this is coming out, according to this, on April of 2021, which means that it's going to be released in North America in May or other parts of the world around that time. It's this pre-painted cold cast statue. So this is not PVC. It is also sculpted by, again, by Restore. And I'm telling you, this piece is just terrific. Looking at the detail, when I saw this morning, I wake up and I saw these pictures. I was like impressed. I was like, oh wow, this is something good. I love the detail. Very comic accurate in that way. It's inspired in comics where he's throwing his, of course, his shield. And it looks so good. Gotta be honest with you, this pose is better, in my opinion, than the pose that was used in this case for Wolverine. Although I really like the Wolverine and I know what they were trying to do. And now, of course, even Sideshow has, a lot of people are comparing the new Wolverine by Sideshow with the Wolverine by Kotobukiya. And actually, they're not mistaken. They're very similar in the pose. But I really love the way he extended his hand, his, you know, his fingers and all. It looks so natural. It's very dynamic. And the effect of that, it's great. I'm impressed with this piece. Now, a lot of people will always choose Eric Sosa. And a lot of people I know, including myself, we've been hurt and in many ways disappointed with Kotobukiya for letting Eric go. And instead of just keeping him on the payroll and, you know, for him to continue his collection with the Marvel Universe. But at the same time, you know, that's the way it is sometimes in business. Sometimes things change and we have to be willing to adapt. But I can say for a lot of people that do not know Restore, he is actually the original sculptor for the Fine Art Statue line. When the Avengers line, the original Avengers line, there was, you know, was supposed to be 1-6, but technically was 1-7. He was the original creator of those pieces. He's the sculptor of those. That collection included Captain America, Iron Man, and Thor. And I love Captain America there, the classic suit. And also I love Thor, the more modern version of Thor. But also, you know, he was the one that sculpted Captain America and Bucky Barnes. There was a diorama that you have to buy two parts separate. He is very familiar with these pieces. You know, he's familiar with Captain America, he's familiar with Kotobukiya. So he's not a newcomer. He's a great artist, well-respected and renowned in Japan. And I think that here you can see his talent on display. Of course, you know, there are concerns here in regards to leaning, how heavy this piece is going to be, is going to stand the test of time. Of course, prototypes always look amazing, but at the final product, if that's the question, it would be just like this. And that's, you know, valid concerns. The shield is held by this construct of this explosion. Everything is kind of blowing up. And I think it is a nice idea, the way they do it. As you can see right here, you can see it better. Now, the only thing here is like this little piece that you can see right there that is holding the shield in between that the stone. I don't know, that looks like a pig. It's kind of, I think they need to kind of hide that a little better. I think that would be a concern. And again, like as you can see that leaning there because he's coming forward. One thing I would say about Restore, he's very good at this kind of action poses. The way he, you know, presents movement, he's very good. Eric Sosa was fantastic when it comes to anatomy. He's fantastic. And most of his statues, if you see them, they have some dynamic strength, but mostly they're pretty much more settled pieces. You know, they're the guy standing there, probably flexing some muscles and stuff like that. But he is not as dynamic. Also reminds me a little bit of the last Bowen action piece of Captain America, and very nice piece as well. Really like this. I really like this concept. I think, and not only that, I love the design, the very classic suit of Captain America. Love that. So if the company manages to release the final product as good as this, then definitely you have a winner in your hands. And another thing I like about this is the price point. I was looking at the website. I think it's $320, $25, which is very cheap and affordable in my opinion, in comparison to what they have done with, you know, Wolverine, and they have done with Thanos. So I think they're going back to reality, which is good. You know, like I feel that Kotobukiya was pretty much overpricing itself by trying to go too high with the price. And I think they're trying to be more realistic with it. And in my opinion, that's good. But looking at this piece, I really, I'm impressed. The base, if you look at the colors there, it's kind of like a regular Kotobukiya base. As you know, they're not, they have detail, but most of the time they're very unimpressive. So I think that's one thing where Kotobukiya always fails. If you own a Kotobukiya piece, you know that the bases are not always the most impressive thing. The detail is not as accurate or as good And this shield, I see it's painted, but I don't see markings there. Definitely, it would be nice if it has the engraved parts of the circle, so that way you can see the detail. But looking at the face of Captain America, there's some texture there on the cowl, so that's good, and also on the suit. So I really like it. I definitely think this is a winner. So I'm glad that like I mentioned before in previous videos this week, I'm glad that the 1/6 is making a comeback in some sort of a way, whether it's PVC, whether it's DC, with Twitterhead. I'm glad that the companies are paying attention to the 1/6, because I think it's a pretty much a scale that deserves respect. A lot of people are moving into the larger stuff, but I do believe that the 1/6 still holds a good place, particularly for this type of action poses, for statues and dioramas, that they require more dynamic view. So I feel that this is another way to really showcase the art. And this piece, again, is already available at SciShow, so you can go there and pre-order now, which you feel more comfortable pre-ordering through them. But you can do it also through Kotobukiya, Koto USA, if you're here in the United States. And as you can see, $329.99, which is the price. I think it's a fantastic price for this piece. As long as they stay around that price point and they continue and they offer some good quality, then I feel that the people are going to be very eager and excited and willing to pay the price. So I'm hoping for this to do well and to be praised among the community, but of course only time can tell until we see the final product. And I'm definitely interested on this Captain America. But what is your opinion? What do you think? Are you a fan of Cap? Are you a fan of Carnage? What do you think about what Kotobukiya is doing right now? I know a lot of people are disappointed with the company. Hopefully Kotobukiya can move forward and be successful while doing so. So my friends, thanks for watching. God bless. Take care. And I'll talk to you again. Bye-bye.